In this session, we are going to discuss about passing parameters to a Visual Force page. So we can pass the parameter by using the help of this exclamatory symbol. So if you keep an exclamatory symbol, it will be helping you to pass some certain values from the Visual Force page by using the re-render. So re-render, which will be helps you to avoid the unnecessary refreshing. So for example, if you take for each and every viewing of a page, if you take a refresh of all the times, so it will take lots of data. So you can avoid the unnecessary refreshing by using the re-render concept. And this dollar symbol, which will help you to receive the values from the outside of Visual Force page. So if you want to receive some values, you can use this dollar symbol. Now let's see a small example by using this, how to pass the parameters to the Visual Force page.
First, I'll create new page. So in this example, we are going to access the lead object. So in lead object, we have one page block, name is passing parameters. We have one more page block, name is list of details. And here inside the page block, we have one page block section and we have one more page block. So that page block name is list of leads. So inside that page block, we have one page block table. So in that page block table, we are passing the record set varchar label. So here name we are passed in the command link, so that it's showing this link as like underline. Next, and here we are passing two parameters. One is ID and one more is name. Now in the second page block, here you can see current page dot parameters dot variable name. So this will help you to display the name. And apex detail subject equals current page dot parameters dot variable ID. So this will help you to display the names with the corresponding IDs, whichever it is matching with that. And here we are taken out the related list and title. And now let me save this. And so if I click any name, so here you can see that particular details are displaying. So that means, so this values is passing in the page block 2 and we are getting the details. Now one more, there is a keyword called re-render. So if I take out this re-render, so here you can notice that, so in this refresh icon, so if I click any name, you can see that. So if I click like this, so it is refreshing again and again. So that it is going on the top. So now I just included this re-render keyword. So now I just went to the last record. If I click the last record, so it will display like there itself. It will not refresh every time, so that you can avoid the unnecessary refreshing of the pages. So this is how you can use the re-render keyword, and this is how we can pass the parameters to the one block to another block.